we will talk about climate change, the relation between climate change and sea level rise, from observations from the past and predictions of the sea level rise in the future. And we talk about the intergovernmental panel which studied these problems, the so-called IPCC, okay, that provide the data and a lot of discussions regarding the future projections of which will be the future scenario. So are there some relations between climate change and sea level rise? The evidences, the scientific evidences of relations between the sea level rise and the climate change are very important and very massive. There are data, for example, the increasing amount of CO2 scientists show that there are strong relations between this kind of forcing parameters and sea level change. Now some numbers. The rate of global sea level rise was in the last 3,000 years with a rate of 0.2 millimeters per year. Okay, so the vertical rate is about 10 times the rate of the horizontal rates of erosion. Okay. So from the models, all these present day forms are forecasted to be completely submerged. From 1961 to 2003, from IPCC 2007, the previous report of IPCC showed that the rate was about 1.8 millimeters per year. Okay. Why? In the period 1993 to 2003, it was 3.1 millimeters per year. So it increased in the last in the second part of the last century of two times. Okay. Moreover, sea level rise together with the anthropogenic force of warming will continue for centuries. Also, if the anthropogenic forcing now stop because this kind of processes there are complex relations, but scientists show that this is a recognized problem, or the fact that also if we stop now to produce CO2, the changes, okay, in the climate, and so also the related forcing such as the sea level rise will continue for centuries. Okay, the sea level is studied from the past thanks to the sea level markers. Okay, for example, tidal notches. This is an example that we have seen before. You have here the present day tidal notch, Here we are in Sardinia, okay? And the sea level and the tidal notch, the Miss 5B tidal notch. So 125,000 years ago. Okay? During the last interglacial period. Okay? When the sea level was higher than today of about 7 meters. Okay? Sardinia is stable, is a stable area, and so this notch is at the present sea level. In other areas, it can be at different elevations. Okay. What about the relations between present and future? The paleoclimatic information also indicates that the warmth of the last half century, okay, is completely unusual in at least the past 1,300 years. Anyway, there are some cores that show in the drill in the ice cores that show that the situation that we are now, it was different from the last probably the last million of years or even more. So the situation is very dramatic now. And probably we are not, it's difficult to have the sensibility to see this kind of problems. Overbeck et al. 2006 suggested that there is a threshold, okay, that will trigger many meters of sea level rise, and this threshold could be crossed before the end of this century, and then probably the sea level we don't know how will be in the future after, I don't know, 2100, the future when we will cross this threshold. How much will sea levels rise in the 20th century? This is a question, maybe the more important question, because all the human-made structures, cities that nowadays are at the sea level, probably will have many problems regarding this sea level rise. Surely, the case study, the most important case study, is surely Venice, but there are many other scenarios that we study. So the IPCC, okay, scenario, one of the scenarios, the possible scenario studied for increasing amount of CO2, so with 650 parts per million of CO2, it will produce a sea level rise in 2100 between 0.8 and 1 meters. But there are some researchers that suggest also more. Do you know which is now the value of the CO2 amount in the air? There is a laboratory, there is a site that you can see every month, the Mauna Loa laboratory that provides every month the value of the CO2 Now it is higher than 410 parts per million, but it is increasingly as a curve exponentially, and so probably from at least more than 50 years. Okay. In the last 50 years, maybe I put some gas. Anyway, sea levels will continue to rise even after emissions will be reduced. The problem is that now the politicians are not usually determined to reduce the value of CO2. So this remains a big problem, a bigger global problem. Okay. There are many people who don't that think that the climate change is not true, that CO2 is not increasing, but these are data that are collected by laboratory. These are not ideas, okay, are real data. Okay, this lecture aims at reviewing the scientific literature to date on climate change and its relations with the sea level rise. So, in general, there is a general agreement among scientists that the global sea level is forecasted to rise during the 21st century at a greater rate than the last century. Okay. But this with different values, okay, in the Earth. So this rising will be not is not geographically uniform, because the sea level is not uniform in the Earth. But why? Because the sea is always moving, okay, and there are parts for different questions for tides, for waves, with different periods of movement, okay, but surely there are long periods of movement of the sea that produce differences in the sea level, in the free sea level of the surface. Okay, these are the trends of the sea level trends in the period 1950-2009. Okay, you can see that there are areas where the sea level is increasing faster, areas where the sea level is lowering. Okay. Anyway, in the future, it is forecasted that the mean value will surely increase due to the warming. The ocean thermal value is predicted to contribute significantly to sea level rise, and land, okay, lands in particular tiger latitudes will increasingly lose mass at accelerated rate in the future. So another time, the future is not so big. Recent evidence of vulnerability, in particular of Greenland and West Antarctic ice sheet covering, to climate warming rises the alarming possibility, okay, of a sea level rise of more than 1 meter in this century. Anyway, these questions are debated, and probably the results, we will know the results after the next IPCC panel in 20, I don't know, in the next years, anyway. But which is the factors affecting the sea level rise? There are several main factors that are the ocean thermal expansion, changes in glaciers and ice caps that produce eustatic variations in the sea level. Okay. Do you know what does it mean? Eustatic variations, maybe for archaeologists. Yes. Okay. Eustatic due to anyway to the melting of ices. Okay. Glacial melt from in particular Greenland and Antarctica that contribute very very much because of their large extension. Okay. And the variations in ice sheets. Okay. Then smaller contributions can be provided also by the amount of snow and changes in snow amount on land and permafrost, because there is a lot of water that is concentrated in the permafrost, and when due to the warming can flow in the seawater. Okay, so this is a short table showing the contribution to sea level rise to the different factors. If you are interested, the lectures are online. So, regarding the ocean thermal expansion, instrumental records, okay, show that the world's oceans have warmed since 1960s, okay, accounting in this period for more than 80% of the changes in the total amount of energy of the Earth climate system, okay, and in particular in the period 1961-2003, IPCC 2007, in the ocean layer between 0 to 3,000 meter of depth, ocean layer has absorbed 14.1 joules of energy, okay, while in the period of only 10 years from 1993 to 2003, the corresponding rate of warming in the shallower, okay, 0 to 700 meters was higher, to 0.5 meters, okay? The other factor, important factor, is the change in glaciers and ice caps. During the 20th century, glaciers and ice caps have been affected by very significant mass losses. It is not general, but 90% of glaciers lost mass. These losses are estimated to have contributed as 0.5 about millimeter per year in the period 1961-2003, and 0.77 in the next 10 years. Okay, so very, very strong in the last 10 years. So it means that it is a process that is increasing in these years. Regarding the glacial belt in Greenland and Antarctica, that is anyway debated now, the growing or shrinking over time scale, so longer than a decade, okay, of the Greenland and Antarctica ice sheets have not been well established from observations. There are many, many stations, many measurements in Greenland and Antarctica. There are in the last year some convergence about the isostasy of these lands, but there are many problems about the total amount of glaciers. So the lack of agreement between the techniques and also the small number of estimates preclude or do not allow to provide good estimates with corrected, statistically analyzed value for changes in ice sheet mass balance. Anyway, a general acceleration in the rate of glaciers, the draining of waters from the interior of the glaciers have been observed. Snow on land, snow cover has decreased in most regions of the Earth, in particular during the spring season. So during winter the values remain the same, but during season and also during autumn usually are lower. The observation with the satellites show that in the northern hemisphere snow cover, okay, show a decrease in every month in the first period of IPCC 2007, with a drop of 5% in the late 80s. So in the southern hemisphere, where the lengths are less than the northern hemisphere, there are also a few long records of data. Anyway, show a decrease or no changes in the last 40 years. For these reasons, there are many scientists are not always converging on these problems. Decreases in the snowpack have been also observed in many parts of the world using annual estimations and annual observations of variation. Regarding the permafrost, okay.
Sorry. What is the difference between north and south? Why?
Why? Probably is due to the geographical setting, because the southern hemisphere is composed mostly by seawater. Instead, the northern hemisphere is composed by 50% of lands and 50% of oceans. So it's a geographical difference, probably. But the problem is that we have not a lot of data for the southern hemisphere. Okay, and for these reasons, there are also many diatribes between scientists. They do not agree. Okay. Then there is a general agreement starting from observational data of CO2 amount and so on, but the proxies are not the same. So. Permafrost and seasonal frozen ground have shown differences reducing amount of mass in the last decades. Okay, the temperature increases averagely at the top of the permafrost layer up to 3 degrees in since the 1980s, so in the last 40 years. From when started this kind of observations. Permafrost warming has also been observed at different rates in different parts of the world. In the Alps, in the Canadian Shield, in the Tibetan Plateau, and in Siberia, where it is very common. Okay. And the rate range from 0.04 millimeters per year to 0.02, okay, in the Tibetan Plateau. But the range is very okay. It is increasingly losing its mass, but the ranges are about the same in the world. Tide gauges. This is more interesting regarding sea level changes. Okay, the average rate of global mean sea level rise from 1961 to 2003, estimated from tide gauge data, okay, is 1.8 plus minus 0.5 millimeters, so about 2 millimeters per year. Okay. Thermal expansions contribution in the same period was 0.42 millimeters, so a very high contribution with variations, okay, but anyway very significant. The contribution, the eustatic contribution, okay, is 0.7 about. The sum, okay, of this contribution is about 1.1 millimeters per year, okay, which is less than the observational contribution. There are many ideas about this, but it is not clear, really clear why. Okay. This is the trend in observed rise in global sea level. Okay, you see that from 1980s to nowadays, it is increase in millimeters. Okay, from minus 150 millimeters to 50 millimeters now, and it is forecasted, okay, to increase a lot in the next years. This is the model that was the projection of IPCC 2007. Okay. More recent evidence using the systems that we have seen before, satellite altimetry, reveal a much higher response of sea level rise to climate change. So climate change is more important than as before thought. The global average rate of sea level rise In the first period, it was 3.1 millimeters per year, okay, which is close to 2.8 millimeters projected due to thermal expansion and changes in land ice. Okay? So thermal expansion and melting of ice each accounted for about half of the observed sea level rise. Okay, so climate change, the changing in temperatures and so on, is affect both the eustatic contribution and the thermal expansion of the ocean due to the increasing temperatures. Okay. Anyway, there are many uncertainties in the estimation of these values. Predictions: sea level rise in the future is projected at a greater rate with respect to the last period. Anyway, there is a general agreement that sea level rise, that this rise will be not uniform around the world. The quantitative projection of sea level rise is very debated in the recent years and is much more debated in every IPCC because it becomes increasingly a bigger problem for people and for politicians. Okay, also all the questions regarding the natural or anthropogenic contribution to sea level rise. Okay, the IPCC panel 2013 suggested that the anthropogenic contribution is most likely a cause of sea level rise. So it's almost sure that it is an important cause. But yes, from a practical point of view, then it is difficult to accept this. The most important uncertainties relate to whether the discharge of ice from ice sheets will continue to increase as a consequence of the accelerated ice flow, or as in the last decades, or it will stop in the next years. There are also theories that we are near a future new ice after an increase in the last decades, then the temperature will drop to a future new ice age. So these are the projections for the next 100 years, 80 years, to 2100. Okay. The IPCC produced the following observations about sea level rise. The melting of the Greenland ice sheet will increase further in the recent future. This is sure. Okay. Climate models in general agree with the ocean temperature observations. Okay. The thermal expansion is expected to continue to contribute in the same way over the next century, since the deep ocean temperatures change only slowly, because the waters that are at the bottom of the sea at 4,000 kilometers of depth, the temperature of that water remain quite stable. Anyway, thermal expansion would continue to increase for many centuries, in particular the upper part, even if the concentration of greenhouse gases will decrease. The retreat of glaciers and ice caps is expected to continue during the next century, and the contributions should decrease after, and some people think that it will change completely its trend. Future scenarios. Obviously, when we talk about periods after the 2100, we are not more in science but in fantascience.
Speculation,
more than speculation, is asinine. Okay, so it's really very difficult to produce scientific ideas. During the period 2020, a possible scenario indicates that the rate of thermal expansion could be 1.3 can produce a rise of 1.3 millimeter per year. So the rate is more than twice than the observed rates of 0.42 in the period before, and so it is similar to the rate to the rate measured in the period 1993-2003. Okay. During the period 2080 to 2100, the rate will increase from 1.9 to 3.8, considering different scenarios of increasing rate. So now we could finish this lecture tomorrow. No, the next after tomorrow. Because maybe we have not enough time. Yeah.
There is no problem if you want to do it something
that takes. I think other 50 minutes, but maybe it is better to finish on Friday morning, and so not Friday. Saturday morning, and so.
If there is something that we want to make the exercise tomorrow in the filter.
Sorry?
If there is something that we want to need in the future tomorrow, something you want to tell me?
About climate change, no. These are only numbers that it's not possible to see in the field. And regarding